day 5 of the 27th Winter Universiade in Granada, and fans and athletes alike are enjoying these games of Spain. In today's highlights, a battle in women's hockey between Japan and the United States. We'll then move to the igloo for the beauty and grace of ice dancing's free skate. At the Granada Sports Palace, the United States and Kazakhstan will do battle in men's hockey. And up in the Sierra Nevada mountains, changing conditions make for a challenging Super G portion of the men's alpine combined. Japan and the United States meet in women's hockey action at the Mulafen Pavilion here in Granada. Japan 1-0 so far in the tournament, and the United States coming off a loss, looking to find a way to get into the win column. And there you see the Americans, followed by the Japanese squad. Starting goaltender for the United States will be Caitlin Nozanoff. There you see her in the foreground. And for Japan, it'll be Nana Fujimoto. And after the Fisu anthem, the two captains will exchange gifts. It will be just about underway. Japan in white and the United States in blue. Japan wins the opening faceoff. And the first chance for Japan, it'll be in tight there. Moeki Fujimoto is denied by Nozanoff. Now on the power play for Japan. Here's a shot from Koike. It deflects right over to Osawa, but a nice sliding save from Nozanoff. And we got a good replay of it here. Good push off with her left foot. And the Japanese defenseman falls at center ice, and the Americans in. Slap shot there from Kendra Myers, but is denied by Fujimoto. Japan now with the puck in their own zone, but they will turn it over. Caitlin Augustine with the setup there for Kaylee Mooney, who misses the net. Now Japan on a two-player advantage. Nice stop there by Nozanoff, but she gets bumped in front and can't quite recover. The puck comes in front, and it is swept home there. That is Moeki Fujimoto with the goal. Haruna Yoneyama with the assist. There you see Nozanoff just unable to get back into her crease to make the stop. After the first period of play, 1-0 Japan in front. In the second, perfect setup there, Molly O'Neill, but she slides it just wide of the net. You see there the perfect pass, but she can't put it home. And then Japan again on the power play. It is Osawa looking to build the lead for the Japanese, but she is denied by Nozanoff. Toko there denied by the American goaltender. Thought that one squeezed through her pads, but it did not. Then the Americans with the man advantage. Pass right down there to Emily Ford, but she's unable to tuck it past the Japanese keeper. So no scoring in the second period, still 1-0 Japan. And the Americans now on the power play. And that wrister from Molly O'Neill gets past Fujimoto, and she's excited, as are her teammates. And we are knotted at one. A good view here as Nozanoff as well in her own net celebrating that goal. But Japan a little bit later on. This will be Suzuki from the blue line. On the power play with under 4 minutes to go, and that screenshot eludes the American goaltender Nozanoff. The Americans again facing penalty trouble. And Japan will work it around here in behind the net. And eventually out in front, the turnover there. Nozanoff with the initial stop, but she can't control the rebound, and Fujimoto with her second of the evening. And that'll put Japan in front 3-1. Good replay there as you see that rebound unable to be corralled by Nozanoff. Another power play for the Japanese, and on the 2-on-1, That'll be Runa Moritake, who puts it through the five hole of Nozanov. Three power play goals in the last 3 minutes of play blow this one open, and the Japanese now in front 4-1. And there you see Nozanov, who's had a strong night, but was unable to limit the Japanese power play late in this hockey game. And that will be it. Final score, 4-1 for Japan. Final shots on goal, 47-16 in favor of the Japanese. So Japan moves to 2-0. The Americans fall to 0-2 and are now out of medal contention. Haruna Yonayama of Japan sits second in tournament scoring with 7 points in two games. Japan will next take on China, while the U.S. will play Spain. From the Universiad Igloo here in Granada, this is the free skate for ice dance competitors. Great crowd on hand here tonight. Full house at the Igloo. And it's really a battle between two pairs for gold. The Italian pair and the Spanish pair. But first up, we will look at the Slovakian duo of Federica Testa and Lucas Soli. They were third after the short dance. These two are the three-time Slovak national champions. They've competed at three world championships and were first alternates for the Sochi Olympics. You see their combination spin. Testa and Soli competed at the Universiad in Trentino and came just short of winning a bronze medal. And there's their straight line lift. Here in Granada, they're skating to Welcome to the Circus. Testa was actually born in Milan and competed for Italy until 2011. And she became a Slovak citizen in 2013. So they're in a battle with a pair of Russians for the bronze medal, probably too far back to compete for silver and gold. But there you see the end of their performance, a really solid performance by the Slovaks. And we'll now move to the Spanish pair, Sarah Hurtado and Adria Diaz. Of course, this large Spanish crowd here to cheer them on. And there's their first lift. They're skating here to Meditation Atonement. Hurtado and Diaz are also veterans of Universiad, having competed both in Trentino and in Erzurum. In 2013 in Trentino, they finished in eighth place, while in Turkey in 2011, they came close to the medals, finishing fourth. You see the completion there of their combination spin. Their third lift of their program. At the recent 2015 European Championships, they finished fifth. And a year ago at the Sochi Olympics, had a strong performance there, placing 13th. They scored 63.12 in the short dance to be just behind the Italian pair of Guignard and Fabri. They need a really strong score here to have a shot at the gold medal. Here is their final spin. And you hear the huge roar of the crowd. And a bit of a tear there in the eye of Hurtado. hearing that great roar from the Granada faithful. And now to the leaders, Charlene Guignard and Marco Fabbri of Italy. As mentioned, they were just ahead of the Spanish pair, scoring 64.44 in the short dance. There's their first lift. Their music here is from Lord of the Dance. It's called Reel Around the Sun. Guignard and Fabbri also competed at the Olympics in Sochi, placing 14th. And then at the 2014 World Championships in Saitama, they also competed there. And there's their combination spin. And a beautiful lift sequence there by the Italian duo. Guignard was born in France and competed for France, but became an Italian citizen in 2013. They're needing to outpace the Spanish pair of Hurtado and Diaz to claim the gold medal. Here's their rotational lift. Incredible strength and speed through it. And you can see they're both really ecstatic with that performance. And the question now is whether it'll be enough to give them the gold medal. And in the kiss and cry, they wait for the results. And they do take the gold medal. Charlene Guignard and Marco Fabbri of Italy, as they score 100.54 in the free dance. Gold is theirs. Silver belongs to Sara Hurtado and Adria Diaz of Spain. They scored just behind in the free dance, 100.44. And bronze goes to Federica Testa and Lukáš Soli of Slovakia. Great crowd on hand at the Granada Sports Palace to witness Kazakhstan taking on the United States. Kazakhstan 1-0 after a 3-2 win over Japan, while the United States dropped their opener to Japan with an equal 3-2 score. You see some of the Kazakh supporters here. And Kazakhstan in their traditional light blue make their way to the ice. Red, white, and blue of the United States now make an appearance. Starting goaltender for Kazakhstan will be number 20, Mikhail Shmelnikov. And for the United States, it'll be number 30, Matt Cooper. Physical play here in the early going of the first period. But that shot will deflect off of Vladislav Yelikov and then hits Luke Hannon before getting past Kazakh goalkeeper Smolnikov. Get a good view of it right here. The puck was going well wide before Hannon was able to tip it home. Now Kazakhstan on the power play. Belgabayev with a shot easily gloved there by Cooper. Now a two-man advantage for Kazakhstan. Ishmamatiev with that shot, Yelikov with the screen in front. Kazakhstan keeps the pressure on. Grebenshikov with a shot, that one too also controlled by Cooper. Now the Americans on the power play. Balint with the shot, he stopped by Shmolnikov. Now late in the first. Great little burst of speed there by Sean Murphy as he leads his way through for the wrister. But that one denied. Now in the second period, the Americans on the power play. Initial shot by Connor Schmidt, big rebound, and that is backhanded by McGovern. Deflects off of Michael Harris, who plays at Ohio University. And that'll put the Americans up 2-0. And here Bryce Johnson left wide open in the slot, but Shmolnikov grabs that one. Here's a replay of it again. Now a Kazakhstan power play midway through the second period. Kukulin with the shot, but that one deflects up and over the glass and out of play. On the same power play, the puck will come down to Nesterov, and a beautiful play there as he gets all the Americans leaning one way and then sends the pass back to Kenbaev, who pots it for Kazakhstan. You can see there all the Americans looking the wrong way, but Kenbaev comes in from behind, and a beautiful play by Kazakhstan to get on the board. And then another wonderful play here. That is Belgabayev with a great inside-out move on U.S. defenseman Chris Joseph, but he's stopped by Cooper. Then it's Joey Breslin with the shot and rebound opportunity, but you'll see here he's denied by Shmolnikov. Now Breslin over to Kazak for the chance. And late in the third, chance there for the Americans, but the puck finds its way up the boards. The Americans get caught a little bit deep, and Zidakov puts it home to tie things at 2 with under a minute left, much to the delight of the fans. You'll see there Joseph caught well back, and Cooper cannot see the puck through the legs. And Kazakhstan ties it at 2. We move now into overtime. Connor Schmidt with that opportunity, stopped by Shmolnikov. And a turnover here very late in overtime, and Schmidt with the slap shot just goes wide. And as the horn goes, we will head now to the shootout. First U.S. shooter will be Bryce Johnson. And the move made famous by Detroit Red Wing Pavel Datsyuk cannot be stopped by Shmolnikov. Kukulin has to score. He can't. And Matt Cooper and the Americans celebrate a 3-2 shootout victory over Kazakhstan. A great hockey game enjoyed by the large crowd at the Granada Sports Palace. Final shots on goal 40-31 in favor of Kazakhstan. Kazakhstan will finish atop the group with one win and one overtime loss for 4 points, while the U.S. will finish with one overtime win and one loss. And so they will now have to try to qualify for the quarterfinals through the play-in round of the tournament. Their opponent in that round has not yet been determined. And there you get a look at the standings in Group C. In the Sierra Nevada Mountains, the site of Alpine Combined for men. First up, it will be the Super G competition. You can see a clear, sunny day, though it is cooler than it's been over the course of the last couple days, temperature at about minus 16 degrees Celsius. There you see some of the final preparations from medical athletes and coaches. First up, Vincent Lajoie of Canada. Has had some top 10 finishes in FIS races back in Canada and also Japan over the course of the last year. He attends l'Université de Montréal back in his home country. As he's building really good speed here for the latter portion of the course. Holding that turn tightly as he'll make his way into the final set of turns. Maxim Shtukov, the man to beat right now, and Lajoie does it. A little over half a second ahead, and he will currently move into first place. Next up, another Canadian. This is William Schuessler Bedard. He competed in the Super G competition back at Universiade on February 6th, but did not finish the race. He finished 8th in a Super G at last year's Canadian National Championships. And there you see at the interval, over a half a second behind Lajoie. But he appears appears to be picking up speed through the latter portion of the run. Holding pretty good control on his skis here through these final turns. But will he have picked up enough time to overtake his countrymate Vincent Lajoie? As he comes to the line, he does. 24 one-hundredths of a second ahead, and he will now move into first place. Now this is Axel William Patrickson of Norway. He too did not finish the Super G here in Granada, much the same as Schussler Bedard of Canada. He's a first-time Universiade athlete. Almost flies a little bit out of control off that one turn, but regains it quickly. Again, picking up speed in the lower half of the course. There's the time to beat from Schussler Bedard. And Patrickson does it in the narrowest of margins, 1/100th of a second ahead. And he will bump out the Canadian and move into top spot. Next up, Michelangelo Tentori of Italy. Unlike the previous two skiers we talked about, Tentori had a great day in the men's Super G 2 days ago, winning gold. He is very comfortable with this course. This is his second Universiade. He competed at home in Trentino back in 2011, finishing 10th in the downhill and 11th in the Super G. You can see really good speed here in these latter sections, carving quite hard through these turns. As he makes his way down to the finish line, he will move ahead of Patrickson by a half a second. So is now Tentori in first spot. He continues to love this Super G course. Now another Italian, Giulio Bosca. He has competed primarily in North America so far this year. On the upper section of the course. Here you get a good view of it, what the racers are seeing. And almost loses his balance there as he fights hard to get that last turn. And he does maintain control. And appears to be settling in here through the middle section. He was sixth in the Super G in Trentino, but did not race it here in Granada. Also did the giant slalom in Trentino and took a silver medal. But right now in the Alpine combined, he's just under half a second behind Tentori. And he will move into second place. You can see now the conditions later in the day have changed quite dramatically. It's become quite overcast and snowing. This is Stan Sugstad of Norway. He also did not finish the Super G here in Granada. But he did place sixth in an Alpine combined event at the recent Norwegian National Junior Championships. So the light, of course, now very different on the course for these later skiers. And for Sogstad, he will finish a fair ways back of Tentori, and he'll be in fifth spot heading into the slalom, which takes place later on today. So there are the standings. Tentori first, Bosca second, Patrickson third, Schussler Bedard of Canada fourth, Sugstad fifth, and Lajoie of Canada sixth.
When education meets sport and culture, what best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.